إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ. My dear brothers in Islam, over the last few weeks, we heard a couple of sermons about racing to do good deeds. Racing to do good deeds, those that are obligatory upon us and those that are extra. Till Allah, till you reach that level where Allah, He loves you. And last week we mentioned how you can come with salah, zakah, siyam, your prayers, your fasting, paying your zakah on your wealth. But all of those deeds can be rent asunder because you abused so-and-so verbally. Or you stole the wealth of somebody wrongfully. Or you spilled the blood of somebody. Or you used vulgarities or were foul in your speech and the likes of these matters. Or you abused, hit somebody physically. And today we want to continue because we should remind ourselves always that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sight over us, hearing over us, full knowledge of what we do. Hatim al-Asam, one of the earlier generation scholars, he said, تَعَاهَدْ نَفْسَكَ فِي ثَلَاثٍ إِذَا عَمِلْتَ فَذْكُرْ نَظَرَ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكَ وَإِذَا تَكَلَّمْتَ فَذْكُرْ سَمْعَ اللَّهِ مِنْكَ وَإِذَا سَكَتَّ فَذْكُرْ عِلْمَ اللَّهِ فِيكَ. This earlier generation scholar, he said, command yourself with three affairs. When you perform an act, remember Allah's sight over you. When you speak, remember Allah's hearing over you. And when you keep silent, remember Allah's knowledge about you. Allah knows everything we're doing. So even though we may build up good deeds, as we're going to see with our last hadith that we'll mention, all of them can be scattered like dust. Allah says, يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَسْتَخْفُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مَعْهُمْ إِذْ يُبَيِّتُونَ مَا لَا يَرْضَى مِنَ الْقَوْلِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطًا. Allah says in Surah An-Nisa, what means they can seal their evil intentions, their evil sins and deeds from the people, but they cannot conceal those deeds and sins from Allah. And He is with them in knowledge, not physically, but His knowledge is that this person is sinning even if nobody from the humans or the jinn saw them. When they spend the night in such as He does not accept of speech, and ever is Allah of what they do encompassing. Believers who are aware of this should not forget that every word, every thought, every idea, every concealed thing is known to Allah, and that they have to behave at every moment with an awareness of this fact, that even though somebody doesn't see you, even there's no cameras hung around to record you, Allah has full knowledge of what you're doing, even regardless of the angels also recording those deeds. Certain verses state this truth. Allah says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مَا يَكُونُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُهُمْ وَلَا خَمْسَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ سَادِسُهُمْ وَلَا أَدْنَى مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْثَرَ إِلَّا هُوَ مَعْهُمْ أَيْنَمَا كَانُوا ثم ينبئهم بما عملوا يوم القيامة إن الله بكل شيء عليم. Allah says, what means, have you not considered that Allah knows what is in the heavens and what is on the earth? Who cares what the people think of you? Who cares if they think you're the most righteous of the people in their land? Allah has true knowledge of who you are. There is no private conversation of three, but Allah is the fourth one. There's no private conversation of five, but Allah is the sixth one. And no less than that, and no more, except that He is with them in knowledge wherever they are. Then He will inform them of what they did on the day of resurrection. Indeed, Allah is of all things knowing. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ أَوَلَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. And Allah says, what means? But do they not know? Do the people not know that Allah knows what they conceal and what they declare? Even if you keep it to yourself, the thought in the deepest part of your brain or your heart, Allah knows it and is very well aware of it. So you may hide something from your mom or your dad, from your husband or your wife, from your brother or your sister, from your children or your friends. You may hide it from them, but Allah has full knowledge of it, and nothing escapes Him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Allah says, what means, indeed, from Allah nothing is hidden in the earth nor in the heavens. Allah is fully knowledgeable of all these things. وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ يَعْلَمُ سِرُّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. And He, Allah, He is Allah, the only deity, the only God in the heavens and the earth. He knows your secret and what you make public, and He knows that which you earn. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ غَيْبَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. And indeed, Allah knows the unseen aspects of the heavens and the earth, and Allah is all-seeing of what you do. So we have to get out of this mindset when we're committing a wrong, where we just look left and right to make sure no human sees us, where we just look around and make sure there's no cameras that capture us. Because not only do you have recording angels, one over each shoulder, writing down your good and your bad deeds, but even without them recording that, Allah is fully aware and fully knowledgeable of what we do, what we think, what we say, what we plan, even if it doesn't come to fruition. Allah says, فاطر السماوات والأرض جعل لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا ومن الأنعام أزواجا يذرأكم فيه ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Allah says, what means, He is the creator of the heavens and the earth. He has made you from yourselves mates and amongst the cattle mates, and He multiplies you thereby. And there is nothing like unto Allah, there is nothing comparable to Allah, and He is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. So Allah, He affirmed the description for Himself. We can't change it. We can't distort it. We can't contort it. We can't manipulate it. We cannot derive any meaning from what Allah gave Himself other than the actual meaning without a proof. So Allah is fully aware, all seeing, all hearing of everything, and His knowledge is with you. And when we see wrong, and we can spread it, when we withhold that, Allah knows that we're withholding spreading those tales, whether it be lying or backbiting or slandering or qila wa qal, just saying he said, she said to spread fitna. Allah is aware of all of these things. Part of that command from Hatim al-Asam rahimahullah was, وَإِذَا سَكَتَّ فَذْكُرْ عِلْمَ اللَّهِ فِيكَ. But if you remain silent about something, know that Allah has full knowledge of you doing that and keeping that silence. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, he said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَقُولُ مَنْ رَأَى مُنْكِرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. This hadith, which is authentic in the Sunan of al-Nisa'i, the Prophet ﷺ was heard to say, if any of you sees a wrong, an evil, let him change it with his hand. And if he cannot, then let him change it with his tongue. And if he cannot, then let him change it with his heart. But this is the weakest of faith. Now, my brothers in Islam, this does not mean that anything we see wrong without thinking, without any knowledge, without any wisdom, you just go and you get yourself involved. Giving nasiha means exactly that, giving nasiha, giving advice. But it requires that you have knowledge. It requires that you use your wisdom. It requires that you weigh the benefit and the harm. It requires that you advise and you do not condemn in order for some benefit to come from what you're seeing. But all of this Allah sees from above His arsh, separate from His creation, above the seven heavens and the earth, above His throne. Allah has knowledge of everything and is fully all-hearing and all-seeing. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. Atiyya al-Sa'di, he was one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiyallahu anhu. He said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَبْلُغُ الْعَبْدُ أَنْ يَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ حَتَّى يَدَعَ مَا لَا بَأْسَ بِهِ حَذَرًا لِمَا بِهِ الْبَأْسِ. This hadith, which is Hasan in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a person will not reach the status of being one of the muttaqeen, of being one of those who is righteous and pious to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, until they refrain from doing something in which there is no sin, for fear of falling into something in which there is sin. This is true taqwa. Subhanallah, if we look at this hadith, this statement, how profound it is that we should look at all matters in this way. Nowadays, we're looking to make the haram halal, to make the makruh mubah, to make the disliked things liked, to make the forbidden things in some way halal and permissible for us to do. Or we belittle a makruh thing. But if you think when something is makruh, when something is disliked, who is it disliked to? Even if something was halal, your father or your mother didn't like the smell of fish, would you eat it in front of them? No, you wouldn't, because they dislike its smell and you don't want to upset them in any way. So even for these things which are makruh, are disliked, even though we've made a lot of them makruh and disliked, even though they are really haram in essence, if we look at it in that way, then maybe we will guard our deen. This hadith was very profound. You won't become someone who has true taqwa, has true fear of Allah, and is truly pious and righteous until you stay away from something even that looks okay and permissible, because you think, what could this lead me to? What could this lead me to? What could this lead me to? Because you're afraid that it may lead you to a haram. It may lead you to something which is sinful and forbidden. Allah said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Allah told us in the Quran, in Surah Al-Hujurat, indeed, the best of you in the sight of Allah is the one who has the most taqwa, the one who's most pious, the one who is cautious with his deen, the one who puts a barrier between himself or herself and the punishment of Allah by following Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and staying away from what they forbade. This is the one who has taqwa. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the authentic hadith, إِنَّ الْحَلَالُ بَيِّنٌ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامُ بَيِّنٌ وَبَيْنُهُمَا أُمُورٌ مُشْتَبِهَاتٌ لَا يَعْلَمُهُنَّ كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ فَمَنْ اتَّقَ الشُّبَهَاتِ فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْدِهِ وَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبَهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ. Our Prophet ﷺ, he said, the halal is clear, the haram is clear, and between them is few matters which are gray that many of the people do not know about. So what should you do first and foremost? You should ask Ahlul Ilm. You should ask the people of knowledge to clarify those matters and rule upon them, not just dive into them. The hadith continues to say, whoever fears these grayful matters and stays away from them, they have cleared themselves in regards to their deen, in regards to their religion, and in regards to their honor. But whoever falls into those shubahat, to those quote-unquote doubtful things, then this person falls into haram. This person falls into sin. Now just to mention it, because we always have the youth around it, Allah knows you, sees you, and everything. But there are things we've become accustomed to in our cultures that they're not the shubahat. And they're not the makruhat, from smoking, and the hookah, and the argila, and the qat, and the grog, as I've recently found out from some that it's used in Fiji, but it intoxicates. These things in some way harm the body, therefore they're haram, they're no way makruh or doubtful. So we should be mindful of these things. عن ثوبان رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال: لأعلمن أقواما من أمتي يأتون يوم القيامة بحسنات أمثال جبال تهامة بيضا، فيجعله الله عز وجل هباء منثورا. قال ثوبان: يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، صفهم لنا، جلهم لنا أن لا نكون منهم ونحن لا نعلم. قال: أما إنهم إخوانكم ومن جلدتكم، ويأخذون من الليل كما تأخذون، ولكنهم أقوام إذا خلوا بمحارم الله أنتهكوها. This hadith, which is Hassan in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, Thawban here narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I certainly know, pay attention, because this is what's culminating, what we've been discussing of doing good deeds, but then doing other things that will burn them up or waste them or scatter them like dust. I certainly know a people who will come from my nation on the day of resurrection with good deeds the size of the mountains of Tihama, huge amount of good deeds. Again, your whole life, not just in the fara'id, not just in the prayers and the zakat and the siyam, but doing good deed upon good deed for your families, for your neighbors, whatever it may be. So you come with sins, with good deeds that day, but then they're going to be scattered like dust, bringing you no help and no avail. Thawban, he said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell us what their description is, tell us about them, so we do not become of them unknowingly. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, they are your brothers and from your race, worshipping at night as you do. They worship Allah in Qiyam al-Layl and Tahajjud, and they do these things. They're doing a lot of good deeds. But what? But they are people who, when they are alone, they transgress the sacred limits of Allah. They sin. Ibn Hajar al-Haythami, rahimahullah, he said in Az-Zawajir, he regarded it as pretending to be righteous outwardly and transgressing the sacred limits. Even committing minor sins when you're alone is considered as something major. Even doing minor sins persistently thinking it's a small sin. يعني والعياذ بالله, some of the mashayikh, when they're asked, is this from the kaba'ir or from the saga'ir? Is this from the big sins or the small sins? You should never look at it that way. A sin is a sin, and you transgress Allah's limits in that way. And a minor sin redundantly could become a major sin for you. He said, the one whose habit is to make a show of being good, but they conceal their evil ways, they cause more harm and misguidance to the Muslims, because this person has no piety and has no fear of Allah. They have no taqwa. They have no taqwa. So imagine coming with all those good deeds, the size of a mountain on the day of resurrection, but they're scattered like dust. They won't weigh anything on your scale because you transgress the limits of Allah. Allah said, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Did Allah not say what means? Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shall we believers inform you of the greatest losers with respect to their deeds? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعِيهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنُّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. They are those whose effort is lost in the worldly life while they think that they're doing well in their work. And others may think the best of them. And they may think they're from the muttaqeen and the believers. But their deeds may be scattered like dust, or their deeds may be put to waste because of the actions and the sins that they do to counter them. My dear brothers in Islam, these problems of doing the outwardly but transgressing in secrecy can ruin all the good we do. Do not render your good deeds to be scattered like nothing, like dust, to be of no avail for you on the day where there's no help for you except the help of Allah, no shade for you but the shade of Allah. So remember that Allah knows everything, sees everything, hears everything. When you abandon your prayers, when you pray them past their time, when you don't give in your zakat, or you find a way to cheap out of it, getting cheap to get out of it, when you cheat on your siyam, when you engage in doing drugs, alcohol, any of those forbidden things, gambling, thinking that they're secretly done or no one will see them, this is transgressing the limits of Allah, and you should fear Allah with them. To recap that statement, تَعَاهَدْ نَفْسَكَ فِي ثَلَاثٍ, command yourself with three things. This was a statement of one of the earlier generation scholars, Hatim al-Asam. When you perform an act, إِذَا عَمِلْتَ فَذْكُرْ نَظَرَ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكَ. When you commit an act or you perform an act, remember Allah's seeing over you. وَإِذَا تَكَلَّمْتَ فَذْكُرْ سَمْعَ اللَّهِ مِنْكَ. And if you speak, remember that Allah has complete hearing over you. وَإِذَا سَكَتَّ فَذْكُرْ عِلْمَ اللَّهِ فِيكَ. And if you remain silent about a matter, know without a doubt that Allah has full knowledge about you. May Allah make us from those who have good deeds that count and weigh heavy on our scales of the day of resurrection, and that we do not engage in the evil and the sin and the crimes to make our deeds become scattered like dust and not avail us on the day where there's no shade but His. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبا على دينك اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام ومن سيء الأسقام يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.